Everybody, and welcome to a live feed update show for August the 10th and kind of sort of the 9th because we had technical difficulty yesterday, so the show didn't get posted. We have so much to talk about on this show, all of the drama and everything that has been unfolded since Tommy's reign of terror began on Thursday. Timmy is an angry little elf this week. No, he's not. But we're going to fill you in on everything that's been going on in the Big Brother house. But first, let me remind you, you can see all of our content at yourrealityrecaps.com/BB21. See where you're landing in the trash draft. Get your flashback times. Get the spoiler graphic if you can't wait for me to go live to tell you what's going on. All of the goodness is over there on our website, so make sure that you check it out, yourrealityrecaps.com/BB21. If you don't have the feeds, get them from us, yourrealityrecaps.com/feeds, or become an updater at yourrealityrecaps.com/updaters to watch the feeds for free. We could totally use the help, especially West Coast or late night people. Now, we are doing these shows live on YouNow every single day, so make sure that you follow us over there. And we're also doing shows live every day on TVCo. That's where our official Big Brother shows are going to be, on TVCo, except for the fact that I like to make it a little bit confusing for you all. So the house guests, like the exit interview shows with the house guests, will be on YouNow, because that's where you all said you wanted them. So they will be on, when we do the exit interview with the house guest, it'll be on YouNow. But all of our other Big Brother stuff will be remaining here on TVCo. And we might have another little surprise with the house guests on TVCo too. But anyway, make sure you're following us on both. And then, of course, if you want to help support our shows, yourrealityrecaps.com/patron. You get access to the patron-only Facebook group, prize giveaways, weekly shows for patrons, special shows like John's cooking show, and he gives away like a week's worth of meal kits. Of course, it's where we can talk about the stuff we can't talk about publicly sometimes. And it's where the after shows will be with the house guests from this season. So come be part of that fun. Of course, you can always do a one-time donation at yourrealityrecaps.com/PayPal, or if you have any Amazon shopping to do, yourrealityrecaps.com/Amazon. And you guys know the deal. Share our stuff. Thumbs up and subscribe on YouTube. Make sure you leave comments. Leave comments on the website. If you want me to reply to a comment, the best place to comment is on the website, because I am there all the time. I don't really wander that much into other I do, kind of, but more like when I'm making the mean tweets videos, do I look at the nasty comments? But make sure you do that. 5-star rating and a nice review if you're listening on iTunes is super appreciated. And of course, following us on Instagram. I love when, and would super appreciate if you followed us on Instagram, because I am posting special clips there that I'm not posting anywhere else. I'm so happy to get to the live broadcast for once, says Ma Shellbell. You know, Ma Shellbell, I'm just curious, how did you know to make it to the live broadcast today? Did you see it on Twitter? Did you subscribe here so you got a notification? Did you see the post on YouTube? I've been trying to like, because so many people are like, we miss it live. So I've been trying to post it in other places so that you guys can be alerted wherever. But if you are following us here on TVCo or YouNow, just make sure you have the notifications turned on for both of them. Or if you don't want that, just turn on our notifications for Twitter, because I tweet before I go live every single time. Yay. Now, one last important bit of information, because it was in the beginning of yesterday's show, which if you caught them live, you got to see them. They're technically in the TV Co app, so you can go back and watch them in our previous shows over there. It's just that I wanted to say this quickly. I've been talking to all of you, I've been getting your feedback, and everybody seems to think, like, it doesn't make sense to do a weekly recap show. That since we're, you know, doing a daily live feed update show every single day, that the weekly update show is just, again, talking about the things that we've already talked about every day on the daily show. So I agree with you. I guess that was redundant. So we're just going to have it be daily live feed update shows every single day. And then when we have the house guests come on, or, you know, guests from previous seasons come on, it's all about you guys and your questions. So I agree. It made more sense. You guys would rather have more time to ask them your questions versus us recapping what we've already talked about that's happened in the week. I mean, have a question about it, and then we'll talk about it. You get it? I get it. We all get it. Great. Let's move on. If you have any questions, just message me. Woot, I love you, Eric. I love you too. Thanks for being here and watching live, Melissa, and so many people in the chat room are right now on TV Co. Hit the three little buttons and share the show. Hit the three little buttons and share the show and let people know that we're live. We are going to go back for 1 minute because some people missed it. And redo again for real this time the exit interviews with Jack. I mean, I'm pretty sure that everybody's seen them by now, but just in case there are some of the few that have not seen them, it's really the only point we need to relive from Thursday. So let's relive these for one hot second for the people that didn't get to see them.
Jack, if you're watching this, I'm so sorry that the plans did not unfold the way that you wanted them to. You turned my dark, cold heart.
You also turned me out.
Warm and red again, and I'll see you when I see you. Bye, babe.
Bye, babe.
Wow.
Hey, Jack. Playing in this game with you has been so much fun. Now you can sit in the jury house and contemplate whether me and Holly really do know each other. Do we know each other? Do we not? I don't know. But hey, I'll see you at finale night. Bye, Jack.
Bye.
Jack, if you are seeing this, my heart is broken. I would have trusted you with my life in this game, and it is safe to say you are definitely one of my soulmates in this world and in this game. I love you, and I'll see you on the outside, babe.
Babe.
Jack. My dude, man. At least you were. I thought you were.
Thought you were.
Man, it hurts. It broke my heart.
Yeah.
But
sad.
Love you to death, and I'll see you in Vegas. First night is definitely on you.
Yeah, you bet your ass.
Cheers, brother.
The first night's on you. Shut up, okay? Both of you, shut up. Yeah, I'm getting the other ones. By the way, you can watch those from at BB Apist on Twitter is the one that tweeted them. So if you missed them or you want to watch them back after, check out BB Apist on Twitter. Okay, here are the last ones because this is where the actual funny ones are.
Good.
I love you. We tried, right? I'm so sorry if you're seeing this. You know I didn't want it this way.
First of all, you should be apologizing to us for having to look at you in the stupid condom hat.
I'm so grateful for the time that we've had together in this house. No matter what, you and I are going to be best friends for the rest of our lives.
Damn right.
Jack, I am sad to see you go as a person. You are terrific. But as a game player, I had to do what was best for my game and vote you out. And hey, now that you're gone, I can keep my shaker bottle in the fridge.
Hashtag justice for Kemi. We all loved it. We all loved Nicole. We all loved that from Nicole.
Jack. Man to man, I'm not going to pretend like I'm sad to see you go.
I'm ecstatic.
You are a physical beast. You obviously are a fantastic competitor from a mental standpoint.
And I gotta guess that you're gonna be some kind of a sexy lover. I bet you're a sexy lover in between the sheets. And I'm so sad that you're gonna go, because I'm not gonna get to get any of living through you with the holly and the cats anymore. But I love my wife, and I just wanna say that my wife is super sexy. But sometimes, Jack, I just like it. I like to close my eyes and think about cat. Don't tell anybody.
And your social game was amazing in this house. Thanks, Jack. Bye.
Jack, if you're seeing this, that means we couldn't get Cliff to flip the vote. I'm so sorry. I'll catch you on the outside. It's all love, dog. Respect.
All love, dog.
Jack, what can I say?
I bet you're grateful.
You picked the wrong girl to not align yourself with. Mm-hmm. You are an amazing guy.
Yeah.
And I am so grateful that you are the first person in the jury house.
Girl, you got some sass.
Adios, Jack.
Adios, Jack.
Jack, you are one heck of a player, an amazing man. I've loved playing this game with you. Yeah. You had two girls so in this pretty. Game.
By the way, she's lucky that the best one is last, because if she really was the last, I would have just been like, skip, done.
Put a lot of trust, I think, in the wrong one, is what I'm afraid
next.
Of. I love you. I just also, you know, happen to love your best friend. Oh, yeah. Also.
Oh, hey, she said love.
Kat and I do, actually. Already miss you.
Miss you. Hi.
So.
Bye. The first time. Go. Bye.
Jack, if you've been evicted, it's not surprising, considering you're not the brightest star in the galaxy. See ya, stupid.
See ya, stupid. Love it. Absolutely, absolutely love it. I mean, after all, this is the, I guess, third time we've all watched those together at this point, but at least we're getting it into the show now. So those were Jack's goodbye messages that did not make it onto the show. They did not make it onto the show. And to me, you know, Jack still seems like he's in good spirits. I have already gone on 3 rants about how I feel about the whole Jack and Julie interview. You can watch that back on You Now, or watch it back in the TV co-app on the 8/9 show, the August the 9th. Show if you want to see how I feel about those, because yeah, I've already done it like 3 times. We can't relive it. Now, the last bit of drama coming out of Thursday night's episode is the timer. People on Twitter have apparently slowed down the timer. And they have noticed that sometimes it goes backwards in time. Sometimes it jumps forward in time. Like 7:01, 7:10, 13, then it went 16, 29, then it went down to 25, then to 28, and then 34, 37, 43. I mean, it's going up now. But there are definitely points when the timer like skips backwards in time. How long is this clip to show it? I think it does it more like at the end. 8:04, 8:07, see 8:07, then back to 8, then 8:13, 8:19, 8:22. It just did 77 to 70. But here's the thing that I think people are not getting about this timer situation. And you know that I have always been one of conspiracy theorists on, you know, Big Brother production manipulation. Here's the thing that I don't think people realize about the timer. Number one, that's hundredths of a second. That is hundredths of a second. So I get how that can seem controversial if you're thinking it's going from like 1 second to 8 seconds, back to 2 seconds, blah, 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 blah. Even though a second is super amazingly quick in time, but the numbers that are fluctuating are hundredths of a second. So what I honestly think it is in this scenario is I just think it had to do with how quickly that thing that sent the oh my god, what would you call it? The radar gun? Whatever it is that is zapping to get the exact moment of time hitting, by the time that has to, like, go to the control room and then be, you know, processed through the thing and then shown on the screen, I think it's just trying to, like, adjust itself to make it correct. Like, I think, I think it's correct when it happens, but then the timer, like, adjusts to fix itself. And again, hundredths of a second. Now, the argument is also they won by hundredths of a second, but still. And I know there are a lot of people on Twitter that are like, this is rigged. This has all been rigged for Christie to be safe this week. This is my favorite. All of these people are so silent right now. Like, everybody on Thursday after the eviction was all like, this is rigged. This is here to keep Christie safe this week. Production is trying desperately to keep Christie safe so they don't rig it for a Tommy win. Oh, is production still keeping Christie safe? Is that still what they're doing? Because we've seen 48 hours of crying. Spoiler alert. Spoiler alert for this show. Spoiler alert. I just think it's not that, I think it's not that big of a deal. And again, I feel like if production wanted to rig things and to really manipulate a competition for someone to win, this is not the way to do it. They're not going to do it on something where there's a live timer that everybody can see and slow it down and blah, 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 blah. Believe me, they lived through OTT. This production team has lived through OTT, where we got to see every single aspect of every competition in real time with no feed blackouts. For real. And let me tell you, if we even thought that there was one minute thing that was unfair, there was a million tweets about it. So they are well aware if they want to rig something, the way to do it without causing such controversy. So I don't think that that was the case at all. But Tommy won, and a lot of people were also confused as to why Tommy voted for Jack to go. And we learned afterwards he did it so that he could distance himself from Christie. He did it to distance himself from Christie in the eyes of the house. I see JJ Wisconsin says, Jason was robbed, hashtag Lasergate. I agree. The whole Lasergate thing is exactly what I was thinking about from OTT. And I guess let me branch off for 1 second for two little points right here. Number one, Jason will be live with us on Monday at 7 p.m. Eastern, sharing his thoughts about this season and, of course, taking your guys' questions live. That show will be on TV Co. That show will be on TV Co. Again, any recap shows or any shows with house guests not from this current season will always be on TV Co. Just the exit interview shows with the current cast will be on you know, originally. Okay, so that's number one. Jason will be on Monday. And then number two, speaking of OTT, I don't know if this is true or not, but I'm seeing on Twitter there are people that are apparently editors or writers for, oh God, now I forget, the actual legitimate thing that Nielsen... It's coming back to me. Nielsen, the actual people that deal with TV ratings and such sort, apparently put out a tweet today claiming that Celebrity Big Brother is not coming back this winter. Now, again, if you are a fan of our shows and you've been following them, I have guessed I have guessed already that Celebrity Big Brother will not be coming back this winter. Instead, if I was to guess, I think it could be a maybe shortened All-Star season that we might see this winter instead. What a great way to get the players back that we actually want when they won't have to commit to an entire summer, but could just commit to like a month, and then we could actually get great big players back. Or people are also saying maybe OTT. We'll see. We'll see if we get another OTT too. So anyway, that would be awesome. Yes, that would be awesome if that happens. So whatever. Moving on to Tommy's now HOH range. I don't know. They don't show it on the show, so you all have to tell me if you think that this is a fun idea if we show or not. But it is the reveal of Tommy's HOH room.
He called it.
Now.
Oh, he got
it.
Whoa!
Hold on.
No way!
This is interesting for a few reasons. It is interesting for a few reasons. Number one. As you can see here, Christy is going to have to deny that she knows the people in these photos. Debbie Dawn says, God, I hate the HOH reveals. I know, but just in case people want to see the moment where people are finally, I don't know, people, it's weird. It's like people who are upset that the key wheel is gone. And I get that. I do miss the key wheel. I do miss the HOH room reveal and the reading of the of the letter. I do miss those kind of little staples from BB. I mean, they were just such a staple of the show. I even miss Julie talking to the HOH. Remember? It just seems like that was such a long forgotten part of Big Brother history when Julie would talk to the HOH up in the HOH room. Veto ceremony speeches. They've really gotten rid of a lot of the parts of the game of Big Brother. Perhaps because it's not a game, but it's a reality TV show. Whatever. Wherever you guys are watching this back from, comment below and tell me what your favorite moment is, or not your favorite, your most missed old favorite moment that isn't part of shows anymore. Luxury food comps, says Mal Pal. Yeah, I miss a lot of those things. So back to Tommy's HOH room reveal. It was very interesting to watch Christy have to pretend like she doesn't know who these people are in Tommy's photos. And she did a good job of it. She definitely did a good job in it. Her and Tommy had their own little wink-wink back and forth to each other. Her and Tommy had their own, like, Tommy was like, oh, this is my aunt. I bet you think she looks sexy, Christy. And Christy's like, yeah, she's pretty, Tommy. So they had their own, I mean, honestly, in that aspect, maybe Big Brother will show it. Since we know of their relationship. So, I don't know, maybe that'll be fun. Was Christy's ex in the photo? Yes. Yes. Christy, the aunt, was in the photo. Tommy's letter was from his parents. There was nothing really that... He didn't really read it. He didn't really read it. He read, like, a few sentences from it and was just like, oh, it's from my parents, yada, yada, yada. There was nothing great in it. He was much more concerned... He was much more concerned about making it downstairs in time for his birthday celebration. Tommy, Tommy's cousin was on his Insta Live. She said it wasn't the ex in the pic. Weird. I don't really personally believe the things that a lot of family members say on social media about the players, because, you know, I just don't. This is Christy.
Now,
this is amazing.
Happy birthday to you, Tommy. Happy birthday to you.
Now, here is why that clip, I feel, is an iconic Big Brother moment. I believe, correct me if I'm wrong, this is the first time they have allowed Happy Birthday to be sung on the feeds. Even though it's been fair trade or fair use for the past, like, 5 years, they've been allowed to let them sing freaking Happy Birthday on the feeds. There's no, you know, copyright or anything to it. This is the first time they have not blocked the feeds on us for the singing of Happy Birthday. They did with Jack and Kimmy. Okay, I'm sorry. Let me rephrase. This is the first season they have allowed the Happy Birthday song to be on and sung without blocking it from us. First season. Correct. Okay. I stand corrected. Thank you, my little producers. I didn't see them being sung to, but I do love, I don't know. Again, it was one of those, like, nostalgia things that kind of made me feel like, Big Brother's changing. It's changing every moment. Now, here was the drama that came about after this, you know, or kind of like during, but after, but whatever. Basically, Tommy's first night of HOH, of having people going up to his room and kind of making their pitches and us kind of trying to figure out what Tommy is going to do, there was a little bit of drama, or I guess it wasn't a little bit of drama, because in a huge way, it has started to create cracks within people like Nicole, Cliff, Nick, and friends. So basically, Tommy told Nick, and probably I'm thinking about, it's not definite, but I probably will be putting up Kat and Cliff. It wasn't like a sitting down, we're talking strategy. It really was just a fleeting bypassing thought that Tommy is mentioning now to Nick in confidence. And sure, we know that that is what Tommy ultimately did. And we know as he went through all of his meetings that that was where he was going. But the drama unfolded, or the issues arose from the fact that Nick took that information. He went and told Nicole. Then Nicole went and told Kat. Then, when we circle jerked back around for Kat to go upstairs to Tommy for her one-on-one, she tells Tommy, yeah, I heard that you were gonna put me on the block. I heard that, like, you know, you're thinking about it. And Tommy was like, are you? What? No. Nuh-uh. Who would tell you that? Oh, nobody knows what I'm doing. I don't even know what I'm doing. It doesn't even matter. I mean, Courtney says Nicole knows not to say anything to Kat now. Yes. I mean, look, I don't really fault Nicole in this situation, honestly. Because I get it. After an entire week of Nicole, Jessica, and Kat, mildly Holly, living in that HOH room, Nicole really believed that she had a much closer bond with Kat and probably mistakenly put stock in Kat's intelligence, which was your mistake. That was your mistake, is that you believed that Kat would be smart enough to use the information in an intelligent way. Cut to Nicole later, way later in the morning. She's in the boat room and she's kind of talking to us and she's like, I can never do Nicole's accent correctly unless I hear it. Because honestly, I'm from a town over from Nicole and I don't sound anything like her. But she's just like, how stupid can Kat be? I don't even get it. I mean, you just take that information, Kat, and you use it. You stick it in your pocket. You stick it in your pocket, Kat. You don't tell people that I told you, Kat. And I'm like, Nicole, why don't you go have this conversation with Kat? Why are you having it to the camera? Go have the conversation with Kat, actually. Okay, so then Nick goes up to the HOH room, and here's what I love about Tommy's... I don't want to call it interrogation because Tommy is very good about making everybody feel happy. He's super great, Broadway slash gay slash fake. Like, Tommy is great at being like, oh, I appreciate you. I love you so much. I love you. Oh, I love you. Turn around. No, just turn around. Okay, I'm going to stab you now, but I love you. Oh, gosh, okay. Or don't bleed when you're walking out. Don't bleed when you're walking out. Okay, but I love you. Bye. All right, bye. He's real good at doing that. But what I do appreciate about his conversations with the house guest is he was very, like, honest. He did not beat around the bush. Like, when Nick came into the room, when Nick sits down, the first thing Tommy says to Nick is, you told Nicole, Nicole told Kat, and now Kat knows. And of course, Nick's like, no, I didn't tell her anything. I don't know. Vote. I can't do it. Vote. Home. I can't do his O's. I need to hear it. Aw. I haven't heard them talk yet today for me to correctly do these voices. But Nick was like, no, I don't know. I don't know. I don't know what I did. I don't know what you're talking about. What did I do? I didn't say that. I must have just said it like casually in passing. I don't even know what I was saying. We were all just talking casually. I mean, you didn't know what you were doing, so how would I know what you were doing? I don't know what happened. Blah, 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 blah. Nick is just trying to, like, deflect, but this is not an innocent thing. The ripple effect here really, I think, is going to cause long-term problems. Because, yep, what it told Nicole was, I can't trust Kat. What it told Nick was, I can't trust Nicole. What it told Tommy was, I can't trust Nicole or Nick. And now, where are people like the Tommy and Christie's going to go when they move forward? And I see others as good. I agree. Honestly, I do agree. I don't like anybody feeling safe in this game. I am thrilled that after Cliff literally trying so hard to ruin Big Brother 2 weeks ago by selling out all of his friends and taking a deal, I thought we had a for sure steamroll of one-sided gameplay for the rest of the season. So I do very much appreciate that we are getting this. Oh, each week now, last week, this week, we do have that power teetering. We don't really know, okay, you got it, I got it back, now they have it back, but, oh, Christie's, so we gotta, you know, teeter-totter it a little bit, so I do appreciate that. I like no one feeling safe. I like people really needing to work with people they really wouldn't necessarily want to work with, and can they make the plan, and can this happen? BB Hyde says, that's why every season is so frustrating. Everyone playing both sides and no one keeps their mouth shut. I think you spelled amazingly entertaining wrong. I wouldn't say that's frustrating. I would say that's what makes the feeds fun. I don't want the, look. I have said many times, I think Derek has played one of the best Big Brother games, period, ever. That being said, those feeds are boring as shit, because Derek made sure that not one person talked, nobody had house meetings, there were no group conversations, nobody's gonna fight, nothing is going to happen. Derek had them all on lock. That's what you want? I don't want that shit ever again. No. Nuh-uh. I want, open your mouth, spill the secret, spill it to the other side, make sure that Christy gets it so that it spreads in a paranoia fashion like wildfire through the house, only to be put out by holding Christy over her own flames of chaos, which she created to douse with her tears of putting them out. That's what I want on the feeds. Then again, we've had a lot of Christy crying in the past 48 hours, and, you know, it's not been great. I think Jess knows way more about BB than we think. Well, that's great. You know, I, up until last week, have said many times on this show, I think Jess the person is amazing, but she ain't doing it for me at all in the game of Big Brother. She didn't seem to have any strategy. She seemed to shoot down all good plans that were happening. She wasn't making moves. I didn't really enjoy Jess's game. Last week, she made me eat my words. She did the job that Cliff could not get done, and it was absolutely amazing. Now that Jess is back out of power, she's falling back into her old routine. She's falling back into her old routine. She knows stuff about past seasons that you wouldn't know if you didn't watch. Or she knows stuff about past seasons from being in a house with super fans that talk about the past seasons all the time. She could know that way too. And we know they have seasons in Jury House and yada, yada, yada. We'll see. Here's the thing. I'm not going back to my old way of saying I don't like Jess's game anymore, because she has proved to me, okay, I do like your game now. Just for this moment, Jess is not really doing anything that I find impressive, but I know she has the power within her, and I am going to keep my fingers crossed and hope that she brings said power out of her. I have way more respect for Jess game than I do, say, for a Cliff game. Cliff plays very much scared. I don't like a scared player. Jess is not playing it scared. She's just, you know, not making a move. Whereas everything Cliff does seems very like, I'm so scared. Oh, P.S. All while saying, I'm not scared. I'm ready to go home whenever I won't go home. If it's my time, it's my time, Tammy. Tell me if it's my time to go home, then it's my time to go home and no hard feelings. No hard feelings if I go home, okay? Okay. Cat, if I end up on the block with you, it's okay, Cat. And if you gotta vote against me, it's okay. We're all gonna be friends outside this house. And you can all come over to my house, and you can come stay with me, and you can stay in my special room. Kat, you can take a shower in my special shower. There is no camera in it, I promise. Okay? I love all of you. All right, everybody, y'all, my best. Now, who wants to make me a deal? Does anyone want to make me a deal? Shut up. Just shut up, Cliff. Shut up. I'm not buying it. 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 I'm not buying Cliff. It is all one big ploy for America's favorite player. In my opinion, Cliff's game is one giant ploy for America's favorite player. And you know why I don't like it? Because it's exactly what I would do. Because it is exactly what I would do. I'd be like, I know I have no chance to win this game. I pretty much, just, if I want any amount of money, I gotta hope America likes me. What do I gotta do? Do I gotta put on stupid glasses and dance around the kitchen? Because I'm in. Cliff can totally win. Oh, no, he can't. Gotta ask, who are you rooting for to win? Nicole? Same as everybody else? Nicole. And then, as we said, I think we did this the other night on You Now when somebody asked, how do I rank people or how would I see people? I'll just say my top three in order of preference that I would be happy with a winner at this point and who's left. And this is not saying who deserves it more or who played the better game, just who are the top three that I would be like, this is my top three that I would want to win. And in order, not in no particular order, in very specific order. First, I would want Nicole to win. Second, I would want Tommy to win. And third, I would want Christy to win. Those are, and all for very different reasons. Nicole, because we all love her, and I think she's amazing. Do I think she played the best game? Absolutely not. But I just like her the best. Moving into second and third place for me, then I go to, now since I've moved out of, I'm making an emotional decision, who do I think played the best game so far? Tommy and Christy. Tommy and Christy have controlled or been the cause of everything that has happened in that house so far. You know the reason you all don't like Christy? Because she's been involved in everything. Her and Tommy were a driving force between most of the things that have happened in that house. If they were to go along with a flip, it would flip. If they do not go along with the flip, it wouldn't flip. Christy diffused that Jackson situation. Christy called things out. So I just think for me, on a game level, Christy and Tommy, I think, are the most deserving at this moment right now. And then if you were going to force me to pick between them, I respect Tommy's game more than Christy's game. Tommy is straightforward / snaky rat. Honest, but not too honest. Manipulates you, but makes you feel comfortable with him. Nobody really hates him. Tommy is a very good blend of a social player and strategic player. And I do believe that he's holding himself back from winning physical comps. Whereas Christy, I feel like, plays an emotionally manipulating game, which is, I'm not here to fault anybody's game. If you want to play an emotionally manipulating game, it is definitely a strategy. It's just one that I put under Tommy's. So those are my reasonings. You can agree or disagree. Comment below. I also think Nicole has the best chance with Christy / Nicole has the best chance on the Christy-Tommy side. Ooh, I don't know about that, Jen, because Christy and Tommy are always going to take each other. I do think Christy and Tommy would need to be broken up, and then I could see her going over to that side. I think as far as Nicole winning the game, her best chance of winning the actual game, I think, would be to be in a final three with Cliff and Jessica. I think Nicole's best chance of actually winning the game is to be in the final three with Cliff and Jessica. And honestly, because I think she could beat them in the physical parts, and she wouldn't even necessarily need to worry about the mental part, but I also think that she could beat them in the mental part. So, as of this moment, that's who I think is her best chance to win the game. And I think she could win the game over them. If... I need to be very clear that we're talking right now. I'm talking, like, right now in the game. If Nicole made it into that scenario and she doesn't have an HOH win, I guess she could spin that around to be a super positive. Like, I made it all the way here without winning an HOH. But you know what I'm saying? I'm just talking about, like, right now. I don't want to agree. All right, Kaylee, you don't have to agree. Kat is my fun feeds. Kat is definitely fun feeds. I do have to say that Sis has really been stepping up her fun feeds game as well. Sis has 100% been stepping up her fun feeds game now that she is in her punishment. I guess let's just go there. We're already 45 minutes in. I feel like we haven't covered a lot of things at all yet. So, rightfully so, Tommy nominates Cliff and Kat as suspected. He talked to Kat. Kat cried. I guess she didn't cry then, but she was like, don't put me up. Tommy was hinting to her, like, I might put you up. And she's like, is there anything that I could say? Are you feeling uncomfortable about anything? Yada, yada, yada. No. Tommy's like, I don't know what I'm going to do. Cliff went to talk to Tommy, and Cliff was like, it's okay, whatever you got to. Whatever you gotta do, it's okay. I'm gonna be your friend here. I'm gonna be your friend today. I'm gonna be your friend tomorrow. I'll be your friend on the block. Whatever you want, Tommy. So Tommy's like, just know, Tommy told Cliff, just know that if you are on that block, you're not the target. That's all you need to know, Cliff. So, you know, thus wraps up that night, the HOH night. They all go to bed. They wake up the next morning, which was yesterday. We literally have feeds, no feeds all day. We have no feeds all day yesterday at all, thanks to the competition, the field trip. Feeds finally come back. We find out that the people that were chosen for the field trip were Jackson, Christy, and Sis Annalise. We found out that the winner was Jackson. So Jackson is safe, cannot be nominated this week. Sis got a punishment, and Christy is the third nominee. So, right off the bat, cut to Christy's been crying since yesterday. Christy has legitimately, without exaggeration, been crying since yesterday. I'm not sure that she's stopped crying at all. I'm pretty sure Power of Cheeto has it right here. Here's a great example. Why don't I hear it?
Because ultimately, there's only one person that can fire.
Yeah. How do I know that?
She meant like,
go on. Why the fuck do I have to be on the block? Why does it have to be fucking three nominations?
Yeah, I know.
Like, it's not fair.
It's not fair. Why?
Mm. I mean, Christy, first of all, I just want to point out, Rachel, I don't want to have to start calling you Rachel Riley, Christy. But if there's not tears, I don't know that you're actually crying. You're just making a lot of cry noises and distorting your face. And we all know this technique. We all know this approach as well. This is called the stab your eye to make a tear come out approach. I agree with all of you. Believe me, I am not at all comparing a Christy game to a Rachel game at all. I am merely comparing Rachel's crying without tears to Christy's crying without tears. That's all. Maybe soon we will see Christy crying in an inanimate object. Well, if you're not liked, then use it as an opportunity to recognize that your awful behavior and better yourself. Well, okay, so I think what JJ is referring to is what also has come out of this is they're realizing we were not voted for this because America liked us. Now, we don't know what the competition was. It apparently involved chickens and eggs, which makes me think it was the competition where you have to put the egg, like, you know, up the wire or whatever. Like, you have to, like, move the egg in the chicken wire. However, the part that doesn't make sense to me about it, everybody kept talking about how it was pure torture. Like, Holly was like, you guys were tortured. And Cliff was like, it was so hard to watch that. Oh, I couldn't watch that happening to you guys. It's so hard. And, you know, they're all talking about, like, they were being tortured. This was miserable, horrible to watch them go through. So I'm like, what could be so hard about doing the egg crate, the egg on the fence thing? How is that torture? So there's got to be some aspect to it that we're not understanding that made it torture. Because even Jackson was like, that was legitimately a straight up torture comp. Didn't they have that and Victor played in it? The egg had to roll in the container. They've had it on a few seasons. Didn't they have it? They had it one season where they had to go, like, over the rainbow. Remember? They had to, like, get it over their head and over a rainbow. But, yeah, it's just basically you're dealing with... Oh, that was Vanessa's season. Oh, well, how appropriate. yeah, but I don't know. There's got to be more to it. One of the things I'm trying to see, I know I say this every single show, but I'm so sick of my damn bookmarks not transferring over. Like, some of them do and some of them don't. I'm trying to see if I have, oh, here is Maximus' mom. Going back to Tommy for a second. Maximus' mom got a picture of Tommy's family from the HOH room. So I feel like the person on Tommy's right is the one that Christy dated, maybe? Not sure. Ooh, is that Tommy's brother? Interesting. Interesting. If you're listening to the audio-only version of this back in the future, you can watch the video version on YouTube or our website. I thought, I don't know where it was. All right, well, basically, Sis's punishment is that she is a chicken. She has been turned into a chicken, but it is like the stupidest chicken, Walmart chicken costume you've ever seen in your entire life. Power of Cheeto does have a funny clip of her in the outfit with Christy. Hold on. Do-do-do-do.
I really do miss him. Is that weird?
No. Why would it be weird? Of course you miss him.
And it's only been 2 days.
I just...
Having someone like that in this house is like having like a little piece of home. I think I said that to you too. It's like having a little, like a... It's like a piece of home. It's like your security. It's comfort. It's companionship. It's
talking about Jack being gone.
It's like, what the fuck? Who wouldn't want that?
Yeah, it's comfort and security. Like, I feel lost, honestly. I really feel lost without him, and... fucking hot, and just keep it there
for Christy.
I hope there's a bottle back and he's coming back, because
this chicken needs some
her cock.
Chicken needs a cock. You know, like a cock.
The chicken needs a cock. The clip that I was looking for to show you when I said, the clip that I was looking for about, you know, how Christy is fun feeds. I just came back to me who was the one, and that was from Power of Cheeto. That was from Power of Cheeto 1. On Twitter. I think I know who tweeted the clip I was talking about. Well, I am pulling that up. So gross. Please stop talking about Jack. Yeah, I know. A lot of people not Jack fans. I hope Cliff or Jackson wins veto. Because you want Christy to go? You hope that they win because your ultimate goal is for Christy to go? We can talk about my feelings on that in una momento. First, this is the clip that I was talking about from BB Team North. BB Team North, who does Julie Girl podcast on Twitter, which I love, and you should check him out. He got this clip, which I thought was just A, will make you continue to feel how you feel about Nick, and B, realize that sis is also a level of stupid that we didn't understand, so am I really that mad at Nick? Because I'm basically calling her stupid, too. Here's that clip.
Scared or scary?
Probably, scared. Yeah, look at you. You're in a freaking chicken costume, you
when
fuck.
When I walked up, this one fish swam away so fast and hit his head on one of the little pipe things.
Was it Nicole?
I don't know which one is which.
Nicole's like, the smallest one there.
Like, when I get... Oh, yeah, it's Nicole. It was Nicole, I swear. Nicole, you're crazy. When I get closer, oh my God, they get more scared.
She's having too much fun.
Huh?
This idiot right here, okay? I'm just saying. It is as if it is the first time she's discovered a fish tank. She honestly thinks that they are scared of her because she's in a chicken outfit walking up to a fish tank. And if you did not think that this could get worse, again, I get it. People are going to be like, Nick is such an asshole. Nick is so disrespectful, which I agree. If it's your friend, you don't talk to them like that. And of course, I am saying it for comedic purposes. But if I was in that house, I would probably respond in the same way Nick is at how we're going to continue with this clip.
I said, you're having too much fun.
I really am. I forget we have these little creatures. Oh, guys, we got a shark.
A shark.
What?
It's a cat. Yeah, you guys see this shark on the...
Shark.
On the tree?
Yep, shark on the...
It looks like a cheetah.
That's a cleaner.
Shark, just so that we're all clear, shark on the tree, everyone. There's a shark on the tree in the fish tank, just so that we're all clear. Okay, let's keep moving.
I think it's called a pleco, to be honest.
Oh, it's a cleaner fish?
Yeah. Cleaner
Wait,
fish.
What's a cleaner fish?
The brown one.
With it the cleans? Spots, Nicole?
Yeah, it cleans like the allergy off the tank and everything.
Oh, it's brown. With the spots?
Yeah, like it's like stuck to the...
Yeah.
Yeah, he like yeah. sucks Wait. Up all the allergies.
Wait, oh, that is a shark.
Those are like the same exact fish I have at
Are home, you dumb? Or are you kidding?
No, I literally thought it was like a baby shark.
You think they would put a baby shark in there with other fish?
Well,
baby.
Not like a shark that doesn't eat... That shark that doesn't eat that, that doesn't eat
What do you
them.
Mean? It would eat the other fish.
No, I've seen little like weird looking sharks in fish tanks before.
Yeah.
Oh, they probably say that today.
Just to be clear... She's seen little sharks in fish tanks before that don't eat fish. And I know that so many people were just like, Nick is such an asshole. He's so disrespectfully so rude. I would kind of say the same thing to my friend. I'd be like, you can't be this stupid. I mean, like, I'm curious, are you this stupid? I don't know why. I haven't seen Sis being that airheady. A lot. I mean, I see that behavior from Kat a lot. I don't feel like I see that from Sis a lot. Now, to be fair, I'm not all the time hanging out on a feed that Sis is on. So in other words, if I'm watching a conversation that Sis is in, it's usually because it's game related. I don't just, like, have the feeds on Sis for fun. Because she's usually with Jack. Jackson. Ollie. So maybe she has been like that and I just didn't really know. I thought it was funny, I'll say it. Oh, I think it is hysterical and I think she's stupid. And that's why, that is why, earlier when we were like, oh, if Christy goes, we're not going to... Oh, not Christy. When JJ was saying, I love Kat, you know, she's kind of lovable idiot or whatever you said, JJ. My thought was, no, you still have Kat. She's still in a chicken outfit banging her face into a fish tank. Currently, at the moment. You're like, oh, sharks in a tree, sharks in a tree. You're a special kind of crazy. I mean, Sis, whatever. There's a lot of words. So that was that. Right. Okay, got it. Sorry, you mean Sis. Yes, of course I mean Sis. I'm still dead at the cleaner fish, of course. So now, where was I where we left off? Okay, so they came back. That was the placements of where they all placed. So again, Jackson is safe for the week. Nobody can touch him. Sis is the chicken. Christy is the third nominee. To which Tommy brilliantly used this to his advantage with people, because then he started to be like, oh god, guys, I'm so sorry now. Like, I was gonna put up Jackson. Like, yeah. Like, people were kind of implying it to him, like, oh god, it's gonna be hard now. Like, what are you gonna do now that you can't put up Jackson? So Tommy just basically went with it and was kind of like, yeah, actually, that's a good idea. I'll just make it seem like I didn't want to put them up. So he's kind of been going along with that. I forgot we have these creatures. Yeah, they're called fish. They're called fish. So Tommy goes through with the plan. He puts up Cliff and Kat. And then, of course, Christy, third nominee. Well, this was legitimately the end of the world for Kat. 100% Kat was not a fan. It literally kicked off a cry fest yesterday. I honestly think from the time feeds came back, and like, I'm not even exaggerating to be funny. I think from the time feeds came back from nominations between Kat and Christy, I honestly think there was always someone crying until bedtime. Legitimately. Always somebody crying about what was going on in the house until it was bedtime. Power of Cheeto 1 over on Twitter has the moment that the feeds came back with Kat in the boat room. Oop, I didn't hit play. Sam, woe is me. Woe. I'm stalling. I'm just trying to change something. It's very hard to produce a nose at the same time. Hurry up. Someone talk to her. Thank God.
I'm just super embarrassed.
I miss a warm bath.
Said people never cry during the Vito ceremonies, and that was really awkward.
I cried the very first Vito ceremony.
She does do real tears, yeah.
I'm embarrassed.
Don't be embarrassed, Kat.
I just hate being on the block again. I know.
Yeah, it's hard.
It's never a good feeling.
Yeah.
And I hate that I'm next to Cliff, and,
and what?
And I think that the worst part is that, like, last week we were just so, like, everything was going so good.
It was. Was going so good.
We'll figure this out. Okay?
Yeah, I know.
There's still a veto.
I know.
You know, I gotta say, as much as it pains me to say, I honestly think that the deal that Jack made with Kat, as well as Cliff, they probably both should have taken. Now, granted, it's very easy. Obviously, it is easy to say that because we're in this situation. That being said, if everything would have happened the way it would have happened regardless, yeah, Kat and Cliff could both be in way better positions than they are right now if they took Jack's deal. And I still maintain that Jackson would have been better to go over Jack. But such is life. There are similarities between Kat and Christy. That is why it would be okay if Christy goes this week. On top of the fact that if Christy is on cam, I have to switch it just because I can't with her anymore. yeah, you know, here was my whole thing. I went on a lot of rage against you guys. I went on a lot of very serious rage that I meant against a lot of you because I was very mad about the people voting for Christy this week. I did not want people voting for Christy to be in this field trip because, A, she creates chaos and paranoia in the house, which will create fun feats. And that was really my only motivation behind it. I really do think if you remove Christy from the game, you are going to get a lot less stressful, crazy, paranoia gameplay. I think you are going to get a lot more level-headed gameplay. Because then you always have Tommy talking people down. You and specifically going to be talking Christy. Well, Christy won't be there. But Tommy is very good at talking people down. You have Holly, who talks Jack down. You have Jess, who is going to calm Nicole down. And calm down. You're just going to have like a very neutral, like people are making moves, but nobody's really that paranoid. I just don't think it's going to be as fun going forward if Christy is not in there spreading her paranoia. So that's number one. However, once Tommy became HOH, and then we knew that he was going to put up Kat and Cliff. Then I was mad at all of you that voted for Christie still. You should have switched that Christie vote to a cis, because here is the danger, in the very real danger in what can happen today. If Cliff or Kat win that POV, they're taking themselves down and Nicole is going to be put up. And while the house at this moment also has rumblings of, we can make a move to go after Christie, so, you know, Nick has been talking to Sis and being like, hey, you know, we could make the move against Christie right now, and Tommy wouldn't have to feel like, you know, he was behind it if he was trying to cut her. Now could be the time to do it. You know, people are talking about, this is a great chance for us to make a move against an emotional player like Christie, when we can kind of use the excuse, well, like, we didn't do it, it wasn't our fault. Like, America put you up there and this is whatever. However, I think that is all of them saying that now because Nicole's not on the block. And my fear is, if Christie gets taken down, that Nicole goes up and she could be voted out. Or worse, Christie gets voted out this week, and then Nicole will become public enemy number one. Because Jackson has no one to go after anymore if Christie's out of the house. Holly has no one to go after now if Christie is out of the house. Holly's relationship is good with Jessica, is good with Sis. It is not good with Nicole. Same thing goes with Jack. Tommy, Christie, they're going to go after Nicole. So, well, again, if Christie's gone, then she's not. But Tommy's going to go after Nicole. Now, yes. Tommy has been talking about, but see, without a diary room, we really don't know what's true. Tommy claims he wants to work going forward, him, Christie, Nicole, and Nick. I do hear him having that conversation most often, and he has that conversation with Christie, which makes me put a little more faith in it. But until I hear him say it in a DR, I don't know how I feel about it. Holly almost backdoored Nicole last week. Correct. This was my only thing, is that the people that were so excited to put Christie up because they wanted the, you know, lulls from Christie being up and going home on a Tommy's HOH are not realizing the clear and present danger you're putting Nicole in because of that. That's all. That was my only point. And we'll see what happens. Nick is going to piss off Nicole so bad she won't work with him. Well, Nick has been super annoying about that. Oh, yes. Bamzilla brings up a good point. Veto players. So it is Christie, obviously. Kat and Cliff, obviously. Jackson, Nick, and Tommy. So those are the veto players. Tommy, Kat, Cliff, Christie picked Nick to play. Well, that is because last night, Nick was like so hard being like, I will take Christie down, Tommy. Tommy, I swear, Tommy, this is so unfair, Tommy. Tommy, this is so unfair. I will totally take her down. Like, he was selling it so hard to Christie and Tommy both that he would 100% take Christie down if he won power of veto. And Christie was even like, I believe it. She's like, honestly, I believe that he's going to take me down. And Nick was also like, I want you to trust me, Tommy. I want you to trust me. Like, I'll tell them. If you want me to tell everyone now, I'll tell everyone now. Like, I'm ride or die with you guys. I'm with you and Christy. I want it to be me, you, Christy, and Nicole. Blah, 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 blah. Now, Tommy hasn't said that he wants it to, Tommy has said that he wants it to be that, but we don't know. Well, her only other option was Sis. In the picking, her only other option was Sis? No, wouldn't it have been Cliff, Sis, Nicole, Holly? She had like four options, didn't she? Although I also heard when Sis came, oh, duh, Cliff's on the block. I'm an idiot. I also heard that when Sis came out of the DR in the outfit, she said, now, of course, this could just be Cliff. Sis, she said she has to wear it during competitions. She was like, I have to wear this during competitions and on eviction. Yeah, okay. So then I agree. You're not picking, Sis. Ain't nobody want no chicken playing in a competition. Imagine it's like a balancing competition and you got like the dangling bits hitting into the stuff that you're trying to... No. Mm-mm. Do not want that. I also have, we had another momentous occasion last night, thanks to Power of Cheeto. We have Tommy is officially done with his missions.
Your mission around the BB universe is now complete. Oh.
Tommy!
Yay!
You're done!
You're done.
Yes!
Wow.
Yay!
Get naked! Hey, look how excited Nick is for him taking his clothes. Look at Nick ripping his clothes off.
Thank God, bro.
And then wait for it. Wait for Nick.
I hope there's nothing underneath there.
Just underwears.
And?
I'm gonna...
Yes! Get out of here!
Give yourself. Don't leave me hanging.
Stop it!
I'm so happy for you.
One more, Nick.
Thanks, guys.
Yay. Wow.
Yay!
Tommy's back.
How good he looks.
I'm so happy.
Look at that baby carrot.
Wow. Okay, Nick.
Okay.
Nick.
Nick is awfully obsessed with Tommy's penis lately. I'm just saying. He is awfully obsessed with Tommy's penis lately. That's all. Nick admitted he's crushing on Tommy in the diary room. Correct. Yes, correct. He has. I honestly cannot wait to have this conversation with Nick. Nick is one of the people I am most excited to talk to post-season because, you know, I really should not compare the two at all. He obviously has a career in psychology, but I have a very vast psychology background as well. And I'm interested in getting to know what the motivation was behind the flirting with Tommy. Meaning, do you legitimately have feelings for him? Like, would you consider ever being in a relationship with Tommy? Like, was that sincere or genuine? Or was it game? Were you trying to manipulate him emotionally for game? Like what so many people, and one of the reasons I don't like Kevin Martin from Canada, what Kevin Martin flat out did to William. Like, are you just doing it to play on somebody that you know is attracted to you? And by the way, I wouldn't like it if it was doing it to a guy or a girl, but I'm just saying. So is it that aspect? And then I just want to be like, if you really aren't, how do you not understand how that is kind of messed up? Like, you should know that that's messed up. you should know that that's messed up to do. You know, whatever. Because he's messed up. Yeah, well, he is a little bit messed up. I do agree with that. He is a little bit messed up. I'm trying to think what the other... I'm trying to think if there was any other good moments. I don't feel... It was a lot of crying. A lot of crying happening. Okay. Maybe Nick is fluid in his sexuality. I mean, sure, maybe he is. And then that's great. I'm just very curious to find out what the motive was behind a lot of things that he did. But going back, you know, I think Maximus' mom actually did tweet this as well. Things are getting weird between Nick and Nicole. I'm honestly worried about the future of a Nick and Nicole relationship going forward. I'm not sure that there will be one if Nick keeps staying on this path that he's on at the moment. Because I really do think that he is kind of making Nicole uncomfortable in certain situations. And I don't know. I think he's scaring Nicole. So, for example, this moment between him and Nicole.
Nicole, come on.
Because I see the rankings and I know I'm not anybody's, you know?
If you say you're not my one, I'm going to fucking hit you right now and get evicted.
No answer. No answer. Still no answer. Still not making him feel better. Still not saying you're my number one. And now Nick has to move on.
Nicole, come on.
I mean, the fact that, and, you know, good on Nicole for not lying to him and not being like, of course you're my number one, because I really don't think Nicole considers Nick to be his number one. But the fact that Nicole is not even trying to work that situation is three things. Number one, my reason why I say Nicole doesn't, I don't like the word doesn't deserve to win, but when I say Nicole isn't playing like a masterful Big Brother game, let's just put it that way. Which is why I say I want Nicole to win, because I like her personality and I love her and I don't care and I want her to win for that reason. But that would have been a good opportunity for Nicole to, like, turn that around on Nick. But she doesn't. And I get why she doesn't. She's scared because of what happened with him and Bella. And now she also knows that what she said went back to Tommy and da-da-da-da. So I get all of that. Like, I get her reasoning, but that is an example of why I think Nicole strategically isn't the best Big Brother player at the game. Still love her. Now, two, it's very clear, though, that Nick makes her feel uncomfortable. It's very clear that Nick, you know, makes her uncomfortable in these situations lately. And then, I'm sure you guys know, there was like an incident last night too where they were kind of making fun of Nicole a little bit. I don't know if she was there. I saw people like tweeting about it on Twitter and then I just forgot to go back to it. So I don't know if Nicole was actually there for it or not there for it. But I saw people saying they were kind of making fun of her a little bit. Nicole is too nice for this game. Well, at least America's favorite for sure. Oh, 100%. If Nicole doesn't win this game, she hands down is winning America's Favorite Player. I really do see no scenario where she is not winning America's Favorite Player at all. At all. I think she definitely has that locked down in the bag. One more quick clip is Christy being upset over how they're being portrayed.
I cried more yesterday than I've cried probably in one day in my whole life, and mm-hmm. I was just looking at it so many different angles, like, how could this be? I don't understand. What did I do?
Does America hate me?
This is Tommy's HOA.
And then he laughs.
I cried more. Me. This is me. This me. This hate. Me. This is Tom.
Yeah, no, that was not my screen recording. That was Maximus' mom's screen recording, who has no ability to make a correct screen recording, so she ruined the joke. But anyway, it was just funny how she's like, "Does America hate me?" And then fucking evil little Cliff over there. Yeah. Yes, they do. Oh, God, Cliff, I can't with you. I cannot. I can't. So, there is a lot of different factors now going into this HOH tonight, today. God forbid Cliff or Kat come down, it is going to be scary times for Nicole. So, there is a lot of stake and a lot of pressure going into this POV. That being said, it would be great if Nick won. If Nick wins and really is telling the truth, he will remove Christy. Kat and Cliff will remain on the block. Kat goes home. Kat's the target. Kat is who Tommy would like to go home. Over Christy's tears. We all kind of are. We all kind of are. We're all over her tears. Yeah. And I mean, that's kind of where we are at this moment going into this POV ceremony. So now I will say, I will open it up to all of you. I will open it up to all of you in chat. What are you all thinking? Is there any questions that you had? Was there anything that you wanted me to talk about that I didn't talk about? Now it is your turn. Feeds went down for the veto. Correct. Our town says he feels bad for Christy. He doesn't like seeing a woman cry. Well, it's because you're a good person, our town. Don't worry about it. This was the OTEV veto last year. I have a feeling it'll be OTEV too, to be completely honest with you. I have a feeling it'll be OTEV as well. Yeah, very, very sweet, our town. I hope it's OTEV. They were studying for OTEV last night, like before they went to bed, they were studying for OTEV. I hope it's on hide and go veto. Hide and go veto means feeds are down for like 8 hours. Feeds are down for forever when it's hide and go veto. I hope Jackson hurts his foot for good and doesn't win. Didn't Cliff hurt himself today? I saw somebody tweeting that Cliff tripped, broke the floor, and now is complaining that he hurt his foot. Is that true? Yep. So there's no replacement for the third nominee. Correct. So if, let's just say, Nick wins, he honors his agreement, he removes Christy from the block, because she is the third nominee that we voted on and not one of Tommy's original nominees, there will be no replacement. So that is the best way to keep everybody safe. Correct. Cliff injured his calf. Oh boy. Cliff sure does hurt himself before competitions a lot. I'm just a little man. I don't mean no one no home, and now I got a hurt little calf. Cat, do you haven't been gay? Oh, by the way, don't be careful, Cat. I'm not saying I've been gay. The product is called Ben Gay, and I was hoping you could rub it into my calf, Cat. I love my wife, but maybe you could just rub some of that lotion into my calf, Cat. Maybe you could slide your hand up a little bit, just a little bit. Either way, I'll be thinking about this later in the shower, Cat. I'm sure he's a wonderful person in real life. I was trying to find the I was trying to find the photo of the floor being ruined after he tripped, but I'm not seeing it in my timeline at the moment. Oh, I do see in my timeline. We have all of the people that are at Hearts of Reality. I see my little Steve Moses, my Johnny Mac, my Meg. They're all over at the Hearts of Reality, which is a great charity. BB should award an America's Worst House Guest. I do like that. I would like an America's Worst House Guest. I do agree. I saw a lot of people. I saw Kemi with David, which I thought was interesting. And then I saw Danielle there, and I was like, oh my God, are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? Oh, this is a very good point, too. This is actually, maybe this will be our last clip. This will be the last clip that we show for this show. But this actually comes from our live feed updaters at BB21 Live Feeds, who update the feeds 24/7. Christy's plan, because basically here's what Christy is afraid of. Christy is afraid that, God forbid, she remains on the block, that people like Nicole would want to make a move against her. Okay, Power Cheat, I'll check that out in a second. So her plan with Nicole is to tell Nicole that Holly wanted to put her up. So this was Christy Kat trying to convince
had
Nicole.
Told her. So remember when the whole like Bella vote flip was happening, and right. Bella yes. came up to you yep. and was like, hey, listen, like yep. I yep. might have Mickey and Holly's mm-hmm. vote. This is going to be a code word, blueberry yep. pancakes, blah, yep. blah, blah, blah. Kat, one day we were sitting up here in the HOH during Holly's HOH, and it was Kat, Holly, me.
Right.
And Kat goes, just so you know, Nicole had said that she heard from you guys personally, not just from Bella.
No.
You guys personally approached her and said that they were considering to flip
no.
the vote.
That
so Holly
happened.
Got like really pissed and Holly. Was like,
oh
what
God,
the
that
fuck?
Never
we never approached Nicole. So she, in that moment, I literally saw her. I watched the thought happen. I literally watched, it was like a thought bubble, and she was just like, Nicole, why is she yeah. talking about us?
I don't think she knows what the word literally means, but whatever.
So in the room,
that never happened,
we were talking,
though.
Me, her, and Tommy, she goes, Nicole just has me and Mickey's name in her mouth. Ever since the Bella vote flip, she's
don't
been having
yourself.
Our name. I know. She's been having our names in her mouth, and I just feel like she doesn't know where she stands. She is a floater in this house, and, like, to me, that's more of a target than Sam. Mm. And we were like, Nicole, we were like, Holly, what does she have your names in her mouth about?
Yeah.
And she was like, there's been a few instances. And I was like, the only instance I heard of was the blueberry pancakes thing.
But
and I don't even...
Okay, so basically, Christy's goal here is to turn Nicole away from Holly Jackson. Christy wants to make sure that Nicole is going to have reasons to remain loyal to her, to Tommy, depending on what happens going forward. They also told Jessica about Kat being aware about the vote flip. And again, this is why I know when a lot of you were disagreeing, but let me know in the comments below. But when you guys were disagreeing with me earlier about why I was saying Tommy and Christy would be in my top three of people who I think should win, it's for stuff like this. Nobody else is doing stuff like this. Nobody else is actively playing for the week that they're in, thinking of scenarios to help them in the, you know, next week, trying to think about what other moves people could be making and what, like, what would benefit them to vote this way? Where could they possibly go? If this person goes out, where are the leftover people? No one's doing that. Holly and Jackson are legitimately having sex every 5 minutes. When they're not doing that, he's eating fucking watermelon. Kat and Sis are busy twirling in circles and bashing their heads into a fish tank. Jessica is just kind of like, now that she's out of power, she's just going around consoling everyone. She doesn't have time to game. She has to, like, make Kat feel better, make Christy feel better. It's, like, nonstop. She just makes everybody feel better. And then all Cliff is doing is going around trying to find camera moments. It's just, is that camera looking at me? Oh, it's dance time. It's dance time. I gotta put my special dance glasses on. This is gonna be a gift. This is gonna be a gift. I'm gonna be a gift when I get out of here. I can't with him. I can't with him. Okay, now that being said, I love my Nick voice, but I can't do it unless I hear him talk. It's those O's. I got a V. That's not it. That's not it. I can't do it now. I just don't understand why he says O's so weird. Oh, right. Power of Cheeto tagged me in a photo. Ah, Cliff tripping on the wood. Thank you, Power of Cheeto. I just sounded like Ramona. Okay. Here we go. Come on, Cliff. Trip, trip, trip.
Oh my god, my nose.
Oh, bless you.
Points.
Oh, what did I just
do? What happened?
Oh, okay. That's weird. It also tripped my entire Twitter.
Yeah, I'm alright.
What did you do?
What happened?
Bless
you.
Points.
What happened?
Do we get to see it?
No.
Cardboard. Oh, a sander
caught it.
Oh, caught a board.
It caught underneath it, threw me forward, and broke the
ankle. No way.
Ankle okay, though?
Yeah.
That's why you don't wear flip-flops, Clifford.
It hurt a little bit. It's okay.
That is injurious.
It was sticking out just enough that my
your foot caught it.
Sandal grabbed it and lifted the whole thing up.
Well, I'm going to put that there so they, like, know that's broken. And so we remember.
Too bad, so sad. That's karma. You're an evil little troll.
you guys, my foot got stuck on some wood. My foot got stuck on some wood. Hey, Kat, do you want to get stuck on, my wood later, Kat? Kat, meet me in the diary. Meet me in the storage room, and then maybe you can get stuck on my wood, Kat. Okay, I love my wife. I love my wife.
All right, look. This is like an hour and 45 minute show. Which, by the way, hurts me. Because then people don't watch the whole show back, or people don't have the time to finish it. They forget to go back. You screw my YouTube numbers. But I love all of you. As a matter of fact, the TV Code chat room, you stick around 1 second. Just let me end the show here for the playback people. And then I will talk with you guys for a little bit more. So in conclusion for this show, make sure you go to our website, yourrealityrecaps.com/BB21. While the live feeds are down for POV, you can check out all of our content over there. Trash draft, spoilers, flashback times, or change /BB21 to /BB any season you want. 19, 18, 17, 16, all the way down to 12, and you can get all of our content for any season. If you don't have the feeds, yourrealityrecaps.com/feeds, and of course, we're live every night on You Now, yourrealityrecaps.com/YouNow, and all of our Big Brother shows, except the current season house guest shows, will be on TV Couch. So make sure you follow us on both. So make sure you're following us on TV Co and You Now. It's very simple. It's the only two places I go live for reality TV shows. You can become a patron, yourrealityrecaps.com/patron. Access to the patron-only Facebook group, prize giveaways, weekly shows, the after shows with the house guests. One-time donation you can always do at PayPal, or if you have any Amazon shopping to do, yourrealityrecaps.com/Amazon. And of course, thumbsing up, sharing the show, telling your friends about it, commenting commenting wherever you're seeing it, thumbs up and subscribing on YouTube, 5-star rating and iTunes, all great ways to help support the shows. Follow me on Instagram, please. It's Reality Recaps over there. I will see you guys later tonight on You Now or tomorrow for our next Live Feed Update show. Bye for now, everybody. Bye.